Hi guys, this is Yair from Rain the Dog. Hope you like our channel so far. If you didn't subscribe yet to our channel, please do it now. Also, if you like this video and other videos that we've made so far, please give us the thumbs up. Today we continue with our series of lectures beyond Selenium. And we will study some interesting topic. For example, have you ever bumped into a website that never stops loading? What do you do? Sometimes the web page doesn't load at all, but in some other cases you see all the web elements and they are interactable, but Selenium is waiting for the page to be fully loaded. Sometimes it never happens, sometimes it takes too much time. And all we want to test is some kind of an element on the screen that we can already interact with. So what can we do? I found this website. I personally doesn't have any connection or interest with this website. I just found it in a regular search in Google when I search for slow websites. So if somebody get offended from me choosing this website, I apologize in advance. Let's run this one and see what happens. Okay, as you can see, this site looks loaded. The elements are interactable. I personally don't know Chinese, but as you can see, we can click on stuff, we can go to this scroll list, we can click this button, but it's still loading. If we'll go to Selenium, you'll see that our test is still running. What can we do? Let's stop the test for a second. As you can see, it's still running, yes? Let's stop the test. First, we can do this thing. Instead of just initializing the Chrome driver, we can give it some parameters. I've added a capability which called page loading strategy to be none. Let's see what happens now. I will run it. Okay, the test was passed and the page wasn't loaded yet. So we might have solved one thing, but now we've created a new problem. What can we do? I want to show you something. I've added this method which called return document status. This method will execute a JavaScript and will return the document ready state. Here in my test, now I've made an infinite loop in order to never quit from this loop. And I will return the document status. I want to show you something. Let's run it again. Okay, now we wait for the page to be loaded. And as you can see, we have the document status printed here. I'll stop the test with your permission. What have we here? In the first place, when the page was loading, we've got from the JavaScript a loading message. Then, after a while, it was changed to interactive. It will probably will stay interactive for good. Maybe this page will load someday in some hour, or maybe it will never load, but it will stay interactive. It means that some of the CSS is still loading, but it might be also that most of our elements are interactable and we can already start with our test. If our test was to test the web page and to see if it's fully loaded, so we might not use this method. But now, because we are testing some other stuff in the web page, we could say that interactive is good enough for us. Okay, I want to show you another method that I've created. This method is called wait for page load. This method will call a JavaScript and will wait for web page to tell us if it's complete or interactive. If it will return one of these two strings, we'll break out of this loop and will return the value that the page was loaded. Then we can start our test. Okay, you can also modify this method and to tell only if the web page is complete. A web page will report that it's complete if it will not have this circle of endless loading. In this case, I've added an OR condition and also added the interactive. I've also added a final integer and to tell that I'm not willing to wait more than 5 seconds. Okay, so what will happen if I will call this method? It will mean that I will wait for 5 seconds, and in the end I will return if the page was loaded or not. If any other string such as loading will appear here, the answer will be false. Let's call this method from here. Okay, now we have our test ready. Let's run it. And as you can see, our test passed and the page is still loading, but most of these elements are interactable. Hope it helped you. Thank you for watching. If you didn't subscribe to our channel yet, please do it now. And also give us the thumbs up if you think this video was helpful. Also, please share your thought with us. Tell us if you want to see some other stuff, if you find this series of lectures beneficial for you, and if you want to go more deep into Selenium. Thank you for watching and have a good day.